What's up, guys? I'm Pokerface Ash, and welcome to my vlog. Or not, because this guy is screaming, so I'll try that again. What's up, guys? I'm Pokerface Ash, and welcome to my channel. Today is a very monumental and exciting day in the poker community for all people who are in Arizona. This is a day that we have waited for years and years, and it's finally here. We now have true no limit poker in Arizona. The spread limit is over, and I'm here at none other than Talking Stick Resort to check it out. In Arizona, all we've ever had is spread limit, so today I'm gonna check out the first ever day of no limit. So there's a 1-3 game with a 300 max buy-in, and there's a 3-5 game with a min buy-in of 300 and a max buy-in of 1200. So I'm gonna go check out that game. I'm so excited, and let's get in there and hopefully win some pots. All right, here we go. First ever no limit session at Talking Stick. It feels surreal, guys. We have been waiting for this for years and years. So again, we're in the 3-5 game where the min buy-in is 300 and the max is 12. So we are in for the max. All right, in this hand, I was still getting my feet wet and I'd only played one hand prior to this one. It folds to me in the hijack and I look down at queen 10 offsuit. I raise it up and make it 15 to go. Only the big blind calls, so we're going heads up to a flop. The flop is ace 9-5 rainbow. He checks to me, and on this pretty dry board with the betting lead on an ace high flop, I'm gonna make a down bet and I make it $10. He calls. The turn is an offsuit king. The board is completely rainbow. He checks to me. This is not only a great card for my range, but also for my exact hand, because little does he know, we have queen high. But we did pick up a gut shot, so that's gonna be good enough to make the bet, and I make it 35, continuing my aggression. He folds pretty quickly, so we take it down with queen high and win our first hand of the session. So in this hand, there is a raise in middle position to $15 off of a 2K stack. The small blind, who has about 500 effective, calls the 15. I look down at ace queen offsuit in the big blind. I mix between calling and raising here, and this time I decided to go for the raise, and I want to size up here out of position and make it tough for them to call with a lot of their holdings, and I make it $65. They both fold, and so we pick up a decent amount of big blinds without having to see a flop out of position. Good result. So this hand was the only one that put a tiny dent in our stack for the session. I raised an early position with ace 5 of hearts. The two guys to my direct left make the call and the big blind calls, so we're going four ways to a flop. That came ace high with 2 hearts, so we flopped ourselves top pair with the nut flush draw. I put out a c-bet of $30, the guy to my left calls, and the big blind shoves for about $130 total. We can't fold here, drawing to the nuts, and there is a possibility we have him beat, so we put in the call, the guy to our left folds, the big blind flips over ace 9 offsuit, and unfortunately we don't improve. Luckily for us, this all-in from our opponent didn't cost us too much. On to the next one. Alright, this was the hand of the day. At this point, I'm down a little bit of money after raising pre, whiffing flops, set mining, you guys know how it goes, and I had not topped up, so we're about $950 effective here. Yes, guys, normally I do top up, but in this situation, I had not done so yet, and so here we are. I raise the cutoff to 15 with pocket fours. The button, who is somewhat aggressive and either a pro or a semi-pro, raises to $65. The small blind, who was very passive and liked to call a lot of bets pre-flop, makes the call. And with stack sizes here and my implied odds against two players' ranges, I decide to make the call. The flop is 10 of hearts, deuce of diamonds, and the beautiful 4 of hearts, so we flop our set here. The small blind checks, and I check it over to the pre-flop raiser, as I would do with almost all of my holdings. He bets $105. The small blind calls the $105, so now I'm looking to get more money in this pot. The small blind could have a draw that wants to see a turn card, and the button, who did 3-bet, could show up here with a huge overpair or a decently strong holding, so I want to put on max pressure. I raise to 300. The button snap shoves for 1200. The small blind folds, and I make the call. He flipped over pocket aces, so of course I'm going to do the respectful thing and show my set of fours. He turns a gutter to give me a little sweat, and the river brings a brick, and we scoop a $2,000 pot nearing the end of our session, and man, it feels good.
Look
Luckily for me, I won that hand on my last orbit of the session. I was planning on leaving anyway, so it couldn't have worked out better. I was in the game for $1,200 and I cashed out for $2,040 for a profit of $840. What a great way to end my first ever no limit poker session in Phoenix, Arizona at Talking Stick.
Okay, well, that was a pretty amazing first session here at the No Limit game, 3-5 game at Talking Stick, in for $1,200, out for $2,040. My very last hand, I flop a set of fours against aces and we get it all in on the flop. Great way to start this No Limit here at Talking Stick. What's up, guys? New day. New beanie, son's hoodie as always. I just got word that Lone Butte now has no limit hold'em, so of course we're gonna go and check it out. I am stoked because that is my home felt, and I am so excited that they also included no limit hold'em to all their game lists. So today I'm gonna go jump in whatever they got available. Hopefully we can do just as good as we did at Talking Stick, flop some monster hands, get some semi bluffs through, play solid, and win some money. Let's go do this. I'll see you there.
Arrived at Lone Butte and I went to put my name on the list, and it was pretty cool to see my meetup game up on the Bravo app. And just to give you guys a little spoiler, we ended up putting together a last minute Christmas meetup game and we got four tables running and there were some crazy hands. That vlog is coming next, so stay tuned. Shortly after I put my name on the list, I was called to the first game available, which was the 2-100 spread limit game, still waiting for that 2-3 no limit game to start. In this 2-100 spread limit game, we are in for the max, which is $300. In this hand, there's four limpers, and I have the big blind special, 8-3 offsuit, so I check. And we're going five ways to a flop. The flop is King-8-5 with two hearts. I check, and it checks around. The turn is a two of diamonds. I check, the cutoff bet $7, and I make the call with my pair. The river is another eight, and it doesn't bring a flush. So we have trips, and we do not want this pot to get checked down to the river. It's very likely my opponent doesn't have a very strong holding, since this was a limped pot and there was no betting until the turn. So I want to get value from all of his top pair hands, so I put out a bet of $25. He quickly calls, I flip over my hand, and he mucks, and we pick up our first pot here at Lone Butte. After playing for about 30 minutes, my name was called to a brand new 2-3 no limit table, so I racked up my chips. I was in for $300 and I was out for $335 for a small win of $35, and we're gonna take that profit over to the new game. Moving over to this brand new 2-3 game they just started, we're in for $600 and we look down at pocket 10s, one of our first hands, so I'm in middle position and I raise it up to $15. The big blind, who is an extremely loose, sticky player, he makes the call in the big blind, so we're going heads up to a flop. The flop is 10-8-3 with two clubs. Having top set here on a flush draw board, normally I'll be betting this flop almost every single time, but this particular player loves to bet the turn if the flop is checked through. Also, normally it's usually good to put money in on the flop because people make a lot of mistakes on the flop and they get a little bit nittier on the turn and river. However, this player is a little bit different, so I decided to take an exploitative route. So I thought I would get a little tricky here and check behind, hoping he'll put some more money in the pot because I have this board absolutely dominated. So he checks and I check. The turn is a bad and a good card. It's the ace of hearts. He checks it over to me again, and now I know he's gonna expect me to bet this card given that it's very good for my range. It also makes it very hard for him to continue with most of his hands, but we have middle set and we have to start putting money in this pot, so I bet $15, and sadly he folds, which means he had absolutely nothing, and we move on to the next hand. In this hand, there's a straddle to $6 on the button. It folds to me under the gun, and I have queen 10 of hearts, so I raise to $20. A loose, aggressive player next to me flats, and the straddle calls, so we're going three ways to a flop. The flop is king, queen, deuce, all spades. On this monotone board, having middle pair, I'm gonna put on the brakes and check. So I check it over to the guy on my left and he bets $60. The button calls with a one player betting and another calling. When I have middle pair and I just have to hope I can get to showdown, I decide to make the fold. They both went on to play a pretty big pot. One of them had king queen and the other one had a flush, so we avoided disaster by putting any more money into that pot. In this hand, I misread my cards and I make a very costly mistake. So there is a limp to my right and I'm in middle position and I look down at what I thought was Jack 10 of spades. In fact, it was Jack 10 offsuit, so I wouldn't have made this play. I raise it up to $13. Two very loose players to my left make the call. So we're going four ways to a flop of $13 each. The flop is Jack, Jack, Deuce, Rainbow, so we flop trips. I decide to check because I am either way ahead or way behind, and I just have to hope that the turn brings a card that my opponents will continue with. So we check around, and the turn is the five of clubs, bringing a backdoor club draw. I bet $25, and the guy next to me means to make the call, but the new rule at this casino is whatever chips across the betting line that are in your hand have to stay, so he accidentally min-raised. The guy to his left calls, and I call the min-raise, so we're going three ways to a river card, which is an offsuit nine. Now this pot has gotten pretty inflated. I have no idea where I'm at, but of course I'm not planning to fold my hand. So we decide to check it over to the guy in position, and he bets $100. There's really nothing else I can do here except make the call. The other guy folds, and I get shown king jack offsuit, and we both flop trips, and I was absolutely dominated, and I lost a pretty decent pot there, and I was pretty frustrated with myself because I wouldn't have been in the pot otherwise if I had not misread my hand, and that's what I get for checking my cards through my camera instead of actually looking down at them. Hashtag more vlogger problems. So after that hand and a few other small losses, we topped up and we are now in the game for $1,000 and our stack is about $550 at this point. In this hand, there's a raise to $12 under the gun by a very decent aggressive reg. Next to act calls, and the button, who is a friend of mine and a pretty decent player, he raises it up to $45. I know he's capable of doing this a bit wide. I look down at ace-king offsuit in the small blind, and I feel like it's a great spot to put in a 4-bet, and I make it $140 to go. The original raiser folds, the guy next to him folds, and my buddy on the button thinks for a bit. He tosses in his cards, they all fold, and we pick up a nice pot uncontested out of position. Shortly after that hand, my vlogging camera battery was getting low, so I went to my car to grab my external battery and I found out it was dead. I thought it was charged and it wasn't. To make matters worse, the charger I brought was broken. It was very frustrating because I came to vlog and now my camera was dead. I couldn't take notes, I couldn't do anything, and after that, I lost almost every single pot with aces, kings twice, queens, flopped the set and lost, and the worst part was I had just found out my debit card was compromised, so I had no way to take out more money at the ATM, and there's nothing more frustrating than sitting there with a stack that you can't top up when you're stuck in a game. But I wanted to stay and see if I could run it up, and luckily I did get a little bit of my chips back, but overall after my phone died, it was a pretty frustrating end to a long session. So once I recouped a little bit of my losses, it was time to call it a day. I headed to the cashier, I was in $4,000, and I cashed out for $650 for a loss of $350. This is definitely not the day I planned or had in mind, but nevertheless, this is poker, this is my journey, and this is what happened.
Well, that was pretty brutal today. I'm so disappointed. My phone died, and a guy let me borrow it just in time for me to be able to record this, my exit video from the casino. But we were in for $1,000, had to reload another $400 after getting beat. Pocket queens got beat, pocket kings got beat, flopped a set and lost. Like, it was just brutal. Ended up crawling back a little bit, and to make matters worse, I had no debit card, so I couldn't even go to the ATM and grab out more cash because my card got compromised. So yeah, it was just one of those days that things did not go my way, but I did end up doubling my last two hands with aces and then kings. Oh, I also lost with pocket aces earlier, but got a $100 rebate because of the aces cracked rule. So all in all, today could have been a lot worse. We were in the game for $1,000, cashed out was $650 for a loss of a couple hundred dollars, so it could have been a lot worse. I got really lucky at the end. I got a full double with my aces and then another full double with my kings. The game wasn't terrible, but it also wasn't great either. I think I probably should have left when I was down a couple hundred way earlier in the session. I was kind of feeling a bit hungry and a bit fatigued, and of course I decided to be stubborn and stay, and I think that cost me a lot, but ended up recouping most of the losses today. Being down $350 feels great considering I was down almost $900 at one point, and I was able to spin up my $100 from $100 to $650 and call it a day. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys liked my first Arizona No Limit Poker vlog. If you liked the vlog, would you please do me a huge favor and go all in and like, comment, and subscribe? It would mean the world to me. Remember, we're only getting started on this journey. It's only up from here. I'll see you guys next time.
Thank you guys again so much for watching the vlog. I hope you enjoyed it. I just want to give you guys a quick update on some exciting things coming up. This Saturday, January 8th at 12 p.m. PST, I am hosting a free roll tournament. No sign up necessary. All you have to do is join a Discord channel, which I'm going to put the link in my description. It's a complete free roll. There's no sign up necessary. All you have to do is join the Discord. The prizes will be one unique NFT worth $400, $200 in cash prizes, and the top 20 finishers will be whitelisted to get a No Limit Llama NFT. What the heck is a No Limit Llama NFT, you might ask? Well, let me show you. I've recently been getting into NFTs. This company reached out to me and I was immediately impressed not only by the artwork, but by the roadmap that they have planned. They've brought on some of the most successful NFT advisors out there. They plan to have a poker club in the metaverse, and anyone who owns a No Limit Llama NFT will have a stake in the poker club in the metaverse. It's pretty freaking cool. And I really believe in the long run, this project can be very successful. I believe it's a way for the poker community to come together in the NFT space. So check out their website, their Instagram, and make sure to sign up for the Discord if you want to play against me in a free roll tournament this Saturday. Not only will you be playing against me, but I will be streaming it live on my YouTube channel, so you will also be a part of the stream. It's gonna be a fun time, so I will see you this Saturday. All right, guys, last announcement. I am going to be playing in a tournament at Lone Butte next Saturday, January 15th, 11 a.m., $180 buy-in. Come try to get some of my tournament chips. I'd love to meet you. Say hi. It's gonna be a blast. Again, Lone Butte, January 15th, 11 a.m., $180 buy-in tournament. I'll see you guys there. All right, guys, that's all for this one. I'll see you guys next time.